Section 5.4, Conditional Probability and the General Multiplication Rule. In this section, we'll look at these two objectives. Objective 1, we want to compute conditional probabilities. With conditional probability, the notation probability of F bar E is read the probability of event F given event E. It is the probability that the event F occurs given that event E has occurred. So let's look at an example. Suppose that a single six-sided die is rolled. What is the probability that the die comes up 4? So on our first roll, the sample space is the sides 1 through 6. So there are 6 total possibilities. So then the probability of getting 4 would equal to 1 out of the total, which was 6. Now suppose that the die is rolled a second time, but we are told that the outcome will be an even number. What is the probability that the die comes up 4? So on our second roll, we only have the possible outcomes 2, 4, and 6. So now the probability of getting a 4 in this case is equal to 1 out of 3. So the probability of rolling a 4 was affected by our outcome being an even number. The conditional probability rule says that if E and F are any two events, then the probability of F given E occurring is equal to this formula. So the probability of event F occurring given the occurrence of event E is found by dividing the probability of E and F by the probability of E, or dividing the number of outcomes in E and F by the number of outcomes in E. In this example, we'll look at conditional probabilities on marital status and gender. The data in the table below represent the marital status and gender of the residents of the United States aged 15 years old or older in 2010. So for part A, we want to find the probability that a randomly selected individual has never married given the individual's male. So this is the probability that they're never married given that they are male. So our formula says that we'll take the probability that they are male and never married divided by the probability that they are male. So male and never married would be the number that's in that column and that row. So we see that that's equal to 40.2. And we divide that by the total number of males, which is 117.8 million. So we get a value of about 0.341, which means that it's approximately 34.1% probability that the randomly selected individual has never married given that he is a male. Now we want to look at the probability that a randomly selected individual is male given the individual has never married. So we're changing the order here. The probability that it's male given that the individual is never married. So now we're going to look at the probability of never married and male, and divide that now by the probability they were never married. So our top number is the same, our 40.2. But now we're looking at our total for our never married, which is this number, 74.2 million. When we divide that, we get about 0.542, which means we have approximately a 54.2% probability that the randomly selected individual is male, given that he or she has never married. Let's look at another example. In 2005, 19.1% of all murder victims were between the ages of 20 and 24 years old. Also in 2005, 16.6% of all murder victims were 20 to 24-year-old males. What is the probability that a randomly selected murder victim in 2005 was male, given that the victim is 20 to 24 years old? So the probability that they're male, given that they are 20 to 24 years old. This would be equal to the probability that they're male and 20 to 24 years old, divided by the probability that they are 20 to 24 years old. So the probability that our murder victims were 20 to 24 year old and male was 16.6%, or 0.166 as a decimal. And we'll divide that by the probability that our murder victims were between the age of 20 to 24 years old. That was 19.1%, or 0.191 as a decimal. So when we divide that, we get 0.869109, or approximately 0.869, which would be equal to 86.9% of our randomly selected murder victims were male, given that they were 20 to 24 years old. Objective 2. Compute probabilities using the general multiplication rule. The general multiplication rule says the probability that two events, E and F, both occur is given by this formula. That the probability of E and F is the probability of event E occurring times the probability of event F occurring given the occurrence of event E. So let's look at our example of our murder victims again. We still have that 19.1% of our murder victims in 2005 were between the ages of 20 and 24 years old. Also in 2005, 86.9% of murder victims were male, given that the victim was 20 to 24 years old. What is the probability that a randomly selected murder victim in 2005 was a 20 to 24 year old male? So the probability that they were male and 20 to 24 years old is going to be equal to the probability that they were 20 to 24 years old times the probability that they were male given they were 20 to 24 years old. So we know that the probability that they were 20 to 24 years old was 19.1%. So we have 0.191 as a decimal. And then we were told that the probability they were male, given they were 20 to 24 years old, is 86.9%, or 0.869 as a decimal. And we'll multiply those together. We get 0.165979, which is approximately 0.166, or 16.6%. So we found that our probability that a randomly selected murder victim was a 20 to 24-year-old male was 16.6%. And looking back at the previous example, we know that that was the value we were given.